for today's Rock Fills That Rule. We have a simple but actually super musical fill from the odd time groove master, grunge pioneer, my all-time favorite, Matt Cameron. And as always, before we dive into this, be sure to hit the link so you can download the PDF for this lesson so you can get the most out of it and not only master this tasty fill from Matt Cameron, but also the modified fill that we're going to explore at the end of this lesson. So the fill that we are going to break down and learn today is from the Soundgarden song Pretty Noose. This is the opening track off their 1996 album Down on the Upside. And I feel this album actually has some of Matt's most mature drumming. Matt's always very mature. He's always very musical. But there's something about this album that he just plays so musical and every note has intention. The drum sound is great. And it's just a great representation of why we love Matt Cameron. And, I mean, we're going to study a fill today, obviously. And Matt has a huge fill vocabulary. We know this. But I feel it's really his approach to the grooves and the feels of these songs, and especially the odd meter approach that really sets him apart from most rock drummers. Matt just has this uncanny ability to make everything sound really controlled and, of course, super musical. So as I mentioned, this fill is from the song Pretty Noose, and it's halfway through the guitar solo section. Matt uses a pretty popular rhythm found in many rock fills, some of the fills that we've already studied, but like most fills, it's really the placement of these rhythms and the orchestrations that make them so unique. So the original feel of this fill incorporates broken 16th notes and 32nd notes, but to learn it quicker and easier, we're going to practice it in a halftime feel, which means we're only going to use 8th and 16th notes. And we've done this before. We did it with the Tool fill, the Sober fill, and it's just a more efficient way to learn. It's just more effective. So we're actually going to start the second half of this fill because that's kind of the more challenging part of it. So let's first just get comfortable with the basic rhythm using only kick and snare only. This is 1A on your PDF. Alright, now let's just apply the orchestration that Matt uses for this fill, which is only between the snare and tom 1. So it's not some crazy octopus fill that requires some insane mobility. It's just right here. It's in a really comfortable place. One thing I want you to pay attention to when we play this, though, is really focus on the sticking. That's really going to help you navigate through this fill much easier. Basically, the right hand is just playing the eighth notes. Left hand is going to play the E's and the U's, which is, we all know, the upbeat 16th note. So let's check it out. This is 1B. Let's add the first bar, which is really just kind of a pickup to the second half of the fill. I'll play it first as the halftime version, as we've already been learning it, and then I'll play the full-time version with the song. We'll be right back. pretty common rhythmic pattern. It's loosely built off this three-note grouping idea. But in this fill, Matt is only playing really the first two notes of every third 16th note. So actually, a popular version of this is to incorporate the bass drum to complete the three-note phrase. Kind of like
two,
this.
Three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two.
Now, to show you how just a simple orchestration can totally change the character of this fill, let's just move the right hand between the floor tom and the snare. It's actually really cool. Let's check it out. This is 3B.
3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1
This lesson and got some ideas of how you can integrate this fill into your library of awesome fills, can you please like, share, subscribe, all that good stuff? I would appreciate it, and I know Matt Cameron would be really, really proud. As you can see, Matt just has a supernatural ability to take relatively simple concepts but really make them super musical and inspiring. And that's really the goal for all of us, right? We want to take these simple ideas, simple concepts, but really try to maximize their full potential. And when we do this, it not only helps us discover new applications, but it does something very, very important, which is it increases the quality and control of that original idea. Because that's always the goal, quality, right? We want to play with intention. We want to play with purpose, always. So, hey, I know you're probably like me. You have tons of favorite Matt Cameron drumming moments, whether they're fills, grooves, whatever. Leave a comment. Let me know what those are. I want to have a fun conversation with you about awesome Matt Cameron inspiring drumming musical moments. And I think that'd be great for everyone to chime in and read as well. So let's do that. And until next time, what are we doing? We're staying focused and we're practicing with purpose. We'll see you soon.